Hello friends, I am Dr. S. K. Mittal. In this lecture, I will explain the problem on Thevenin's theorem. The statement of this question is, in the given figure, the Thevenin equivalent pair means voltage impedance as seen in the terminals PQ is given by. There are four choices. A, B, C and D. I am not giving the answer. I will calculate the Thevenin equivalent pair means voltage and impedance from the terminals P and Q. It was asked in GATE 2005. In this question, Thevenin equivalent pair is being asked means we have to calculate the Thevenin equivalent voltage and Thevenin equivalent impedance or Thevenin equivalent resistance. To calculate the Thevenin equivalent voltage and to calculate the Thevenin equivalent resistance, first of all, the terminals where any network or load is connected is open circuited. See here, in this question, between the terminals P and Q, an unknown network is connected. Therefore, to calculate the Thevenin equivalent pair, the Thevenin's theorem say that any network between the terminals P and Q must be disconnected. So now, see here, to obtain the Thevenin equivalent pair, voltage and impedance or resistance, I have disconnected the unknown network and therefore P and Q terminals have been open circuited. Now, after open circuiting the unknown network, this network is obtained. For this network, in first step, I will calculate the Thevenin equivalent voltage or open circuit voltage between the terminals P and Q. See, VOC is the equivalent voltage between the terminals P and Q. At the same time, between terminals P and Q, a 10 ohm resistance is also connected. Therefore, by observation of circuit, we can say that VOC is nothing but voltage across 10 ohm. If VOC is the voltage across 10 ohm, then to calculate this VOC, we require the current flowing through this resistance of 10 ohm, which is connected between these two terminals. These two terminals are nothing but P and Q terminals. Therefore, to calculate the current, generally I use first apply the mesh analysis method. In first analysis method, we have to search the number of mesh. See, this becomes the first mesh and this becomes the second mesh. Since it is open circuited, it cannot be considered as a mesh. Means I will consider this as a first mesh and this as a second mesh. In my mesh analysis method, first I generally represent the clockwise mesh currents always. Since two mesh are there, therefore I have considered two currents I1 and I2 in two mesh in always clockwise. After representing the current, I will write the mesh equation of first mesh. Now, if I write the mesh equation up first, then see, on the periphery of mesh number 1, there is a resistance of 10 ohm and the current, 20 ohm and current is I1. On the periphery of mesh number 1, there is only one resistance of 20 ohm, but the resistance common between mesh number 1 and mesh number 2 is 0, because see, between these two terminals there is no resistance common between mesh number 1 and mesh number 2. Therefore, the multiplier of I2 will be 0, and we can simply write 20 I1 is equal to. Now see, in case of mesh analysis, if I am writing the mesh equation of first, I will see the direction of I1, and according to the direction of I1, the source of 4 volt, which is on the periphery of mesh number 1, is going from positive to negative, means there is a voltage drop, and for voltage drop I always consider minus sign. So this is the first equation, and according to this, I1 is equal to minus 4 upon 20, and by solving we obtain I1 is equal to minus 0.2 amperes. This is the first current I1. Since VOC is the, as I have already told you, that VOC is nothing but VOC is nothing but voltage across resistance 10 ohm, and 10 ohm current is required. Therefore, another mesh equation we require to write for mesh number 2. For mesh number 2, if we write the equation, then for mesh second, see, this is the mesh number 2, and on the periphery of mesh number 2, there are two resistances of 10 and 10 ohm, and at the same time, there is no resistance common between mesh number 2 and mesh number 1. Therefore, what I will write, plus I2, 10 plus 10, and the multiplier of minus I1, which is written in case of mesh analysis, will be 0. Therefore, I am not writing. See, and at the same time, on the periphery of mesh number 2, there is a source of 4 volt, and in the direction of I2, this source is going from negative to positive in the direction of I2. Therefore, for I2, I will write plus 4 volt. This is the next mesh equation for mesh number 2. And therefore, I2 is equal to 4 upon 20, means it will be equal to 0.2 ampere. Now see, I have calculated I1 and I2, but which current is required? Since VOC is required, and for VOC, the current flowing through this 10 ohm, which is connected between the terminals P and Q, is required. Therefore, we require I2, and to calculate VOC, I can assume one circuit, a small circuit, like this. This is the 10 ohm resistance. These are the PQ terminals, and here VOC is represented, and here current I2 is there. This is the mesh current I2. If I2 is considered for 10 ohm, it will flow in 10 ohm like this. Therefore, I can represent I2 as a branch current in 10 ohm like this. This I2 is mesh current, and here this I2 I have represented as a branch current. If this branch current I2 flows through this 10 ohm, therefore this will give the polarity like this. And if I write a KVL-like equation for this calculation of VOC, if I start from P terminal, then plus VOC plus VOC minus 10 I2 is equal to 0 means VOC is equal to 10 multiplied by 0.2 means VOC is nothing but 2 volt. So now I have calculated the Thevenin equivalent voltage VOC is equal to 10 volt. Since in the question Thevenin pair is to be calculated, therefore we require the calculation of RTH also. So therefore in next step I will calculate RTH, Thevenin equivalent resistance. To calculate the Thevenin equivalent resistance, I will consider this circuit and I will calculate the RTH between the terminals P and Q, and while calculating the RTH, the voltage source 4 volt, voltage source of 4 volt, I have to short circuit, because in case of Thevenin equivalent resistance, all the voltage sources are short circuited and current sources are open circuited. Therefore, by making the 4 volt short circuit, the equivalent circuit will be, this is the 20 ohm. Now this 4 volt will be short circuited. In the place of 4 volt, I will represent short circuit, and then there are two resistances, this 10 ohm and this 10 ohm. And here the PQ terminals are there, and this is RTH. Since it is the equivalent resistance, plus and minus we cannot represent. See, there is a case here. Again, a special case. What is the special case? This is the 20 ohm resistance, and across 20 ohm resistance there is a short circuit. Then in such cases, what is the resultant? This is the resultant, because if current we consider like this, what is the law of current flow? Current always follows zero resistance path or minimum resistance path. Therefore, total current flowing from this side will go through the short circuit, and there will be zero current in the 20 ohm. Hence, according to this figure, the next equivalent circuit will be like this. I will disconnect or remove the 20 ohm resistance, and this is the 10 ohm and next 10 ohm resistance, and here is the terminals PQ where RTH is to be calculated. Now see, RTH is the PQ, RTH is the equivalent resistance between the terminals P and Q. Since RTH is calculated from the right hand side, then we have to start the calculation of RTH from left side. Then this 10 ohm and this 10 ohm will be in parallel. So 10 ohm parallel 10 ohm, then it will be, the equivalent will be 5 ohm. Then RTH, which is calculated between the terminals P and Q, is nothing but RTH is equal to 5 ohm. Now, the answer of this question is, answer of this question is, VOC is equal to 2 volt, and VOC is equal to 2 volt, and RTH is equal to 5 ohm. In this way, we can solve the Thevenin equivalent pair means open circuit voltage VOC and RTH when only independent sources are present in any circuit. Thank you.